I'm going to show you the top three mobile apps for live streaming, and these are going to work for both Android and iOS devices. So don't worry, I've got you covered there no matter what you're using. So let's go ahead and jump right into the first one, and it's called StreamYard. Now, while StreamYard is not technically an app, it is a browser-based service. That means it works on all devices, iPads, tablets, Androids, and even your computer. And the cool thing about StreamYard is it doesn't have any updates. You don't have to worry about anything. You don't have to worry about anything not working. You just open up the browser, you connect your YouTube channel or your Facebook account or your Twitch account or whatever you're using to live stream, and it simply works. And the chats from all of those platforms are gonna go into the admin in StreamYard, so you don't have to read chats in different places. They're all in one place. You can also bring people onto your live stream. You can bring your friends on, you can interview people. So if you're looking to do interviews or just simply hang out with your community, this is gonna be the best option for that. And if you wanna check out StreamYard, I'm gonna put a link to it down in the description below, and I'm gonna put a link to a video that I made about StreamYard at the end of this video, so make sure to check that out. The second app that I recommend you use for going live is called Prism Live Studio. And again, this is available for both Android and iOS users. And this app is totally free. And by the way, this is an actual app that you download on your device. Prism Live Studio also allows multi-streaming. So if you want to stream to YouTube and Facebook and Twitch at the exact same time, you can do that with Prism Live Studio, and it doesn't cost anything to do that. They also have some really cool filters that remind me of Instagram or Snapchat, where you can change the look of your stream and add filters on top of it, or you can add stickers. You can move the stickers around. You can also draw on the stream, or you can add videos and photos. Prism also has a screen sharing feature. So if you're a gamer and you're trying to broadcast your game, you can do that with Prism Live Studio, and it's really easy to do. It's a really creative app. So if you're looking for an app solution, download Prism Live Studio. I got links to that down in the description below, as well as a video tutorial on how to use it. Next up is going to be the Streamlabs mobile app, and that name probably sounds familiar because they do have a desktop version of this, but this is just stripped down for your mobile device. And Streamlabs also allows multi-streaming, just like StreamYard does and Prism Live Studio. Now, while a lot of people do use this app for talking head style live streams, it is really popular with gamers. So if you find that you don't like Prism Live Studio, have a look at the Streamlabs mobile app, because they do allow you to put your alerts on the screen. Of course, you can show your chat, you can put some basic overlays on it. It's not the full-blown version like you would get on your desktop, but it is stripped down and it's pretty good. That being said, they do want you to pay to upgrade to use some of these features. And as I mentioned earlier in this video, if you want to learn how to use StreamYard in your phone, go ahead and tap on the video that's showing on the screen right now. I walk you through exactly how to do that, and it's incredibly easy. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.